This is section 9.2, absolute value equations for MAT1033. The key piece to solving absolute value equations is we are going to use this rule that is in the box on the top of the page. To solve absolute value of x equal to a, has to be a positive real number, then you can break it into two separate problems because stop and think about it. Absolute value is a distance. So when we talk about the distance, we could go to the right or to the left. And so that's why it's going to be equal to a negative and a positive. But what I need you to be absolutely clear on is what comes out of the absolute value has to be positive. So I like to break these problems into three steps so that you don't mess up with the rule that is in the box. The box says everything in one sentence, but we're going to break it down into three steps. So the first step is kind of like what I tell you before. You have to get in the correct format to use the rule. So you must have the absolute value by itself on one side. So just going to kind of look at these three problems that you can see on my screen right now. The first one's okay because absolute value is by itself. The second one is not because I have something else on that left-hand side. The third one is okay using rule one. Okay, so first step, make sure it's in the correct format. Second step is using this idea right here. What comes out of the absolute value has to be positive. So when we're saying that, we're saying this number here has to be a positive. But it has to be passing rule one first before you use this rule. So once you have the absolute value is equal to a number, that number has to be positive. So think of step one and step two as you have to go in that order. First, put it in the correct format. Second, it has to equal to a positive number. And it can be equal to zero. But it cannot be a negative number. If it's a negative number, there is no solution because what comes out of an absolute value cannot be negative. What's inside can, but what comes out of it cannot. So my third step is to finally use this rule where we drop the absolute value and we set it equal to a negative a and we set it equal to a positive a. The mistake I see people make is they start trying to change signs from what's inside the absolute value. The inside of the absolute value, right here, whatever it is, comes down exactly how it is. You're setting it equal to a negative a and a positive a because the whole piece can be negative or positive before you take the absolute value. So please make sure when you're doing your problems on the test, these are some of the easiest problems on the test, that you are following this three-step process. So step one on number one, absolute value is by itself. So that's a check. It's equal to a positive number, which is step two. That's a check. So it says drop the absolute values, set it equal to a negative three, drop the absolute values, set it equal to a positive three. What I find people do on these problems is they try to skip a lot of steps. Please make sure you're following the three-step process. So now I'm just solving these. So I'm going to subtract 2 from both sides. Be careful again of your signs. So I get x equals negative 5. On my second equation, I'm going to subtract 2 from both sides, which gives me x equals 1. So my answer for this problem is a negative 5 or 1. Not an ordered pair. Please do not put parentheses. That's incorrect. My solution is a negative 5 or 1. Doesn't matter if you put the 1 first or the negative 5. Super easy to check. Plug it back into the original problem and make sure it works. Going to number 2. I have something I need to move to the other side to follow number one's rule. So I'm going to subtract 2 from both sides. And that has to be done first. So I'm done with step one, absolute values by itself. Step two says, check to make sure that's positive, which it is. So now I can use the actual definition of solving the absolute value. I'm going to drop the absolute value symbols, but notice the minus 4 comes down. Whatever's inside comes down. You set it equal to a negative 9. You set it equal to a positive 9. The 9 is what I'm changing the sign of. So now I'm going to add 4 to both sides. I get 3x equals a negative 5. I'm then going to divide both sides by the 3. That gives me negative 5 thirds. Going over here, I'm going to add 4 to both sides. Gives me 3x equals 13. And then I divide both sides by 3. And if I can simplify the fraction, you always should simplify the fraction. So my answer for this problem is a negative 5 thirds or 13 thirds. Again, it's not an ordered pair. Those are my braces telling somebody that looks at it that that's my solution set. This isn't as easy to check, but I absolutely still can check it because I actually notice once I plug it in for x, the denominator will cancel and it makes it much easier to do. Going to our third example here, I have absolute value by itself on one side, but notice here it breaks what I call rule number 2. This is a negative 7. What comes out of absolute value can never be negative. So my answer here is empty set or no solution. So you have to do it in the order. Most of the time you should expect 2 answers because notice we're breaking it into 2 different equations. But there is one case, and this isn't on your handouts, but I'm going to make an example just to show you what happens here because it tends to throw people off. What if I had 2x minus 3 is equal to 0? So that follows, just because it's equal to 0, still follow your same rules. This absolute value is by itself. This is not positive, but basically that means I'm not going to be able to put it into the form of a negative and a positive because 0 doesn't go either direction. Stop and think about it. Absolute value is a distance. If my distance is 0, I'm only going to have one answer. So I add 3 to both sides and then divide by 2. 3 types of answers you can get for these problems in 9.2. Most of the time you will get 2 different answers and they won't match. People tend to find, they think it's always going to be like a negative 2, positive 2. Which can happen for sure. But notice example 1 and 2, we had different numbers. It can be one answer if it's equal to 0 once you're to step 2. It can be empty set if it's not equal to a positive number or 0, which is your third case. Please check these. These should be easy problems if you've reviewed them.